One of the easiest ways to gain traffic to your website is by figuring out what's already working for your competition. That means doing competitive research. There are only three things you need to find out about your competition to understand how are they getting the traffic. The first thing you need to find out is what keywords are they ranking for. The second thing you need to find out is how much traffic are they getting. And the third thing you need to figure out is how are they optimizing their individual pages to rank higher in the search results. And I'm going to show you exactly how to do this exact things or how to find out these all these steps about your competition in this video. So keep watching. All right, let's do step number one first, which is figuring out what keywords is your competition ranking for. And we'll do that with this, Google Ads. Now you're wondering, hey, why Google Ads? How does it work? Don't worry about it. I'll explain how we use Google Ads interface, or one of the tools inside Google Ads, to do our work. Now you'll reach this page by using the link in the description, which is ads.google.com. And if you have a Google account, you can quickly sign in. I'm already signed in, and this is what my account looks like. Don't worry, what is all this? You might not see any of this if you don't or don't run any Google Ads. So all you have to do is just go to tools and settings right here, click on this, and you'll see a bunch of options. What you have to do is find the Google Keyword Planner, which is right here. Go to Google Keyword Planner, and this is the interface you will see. Let it load up for a second and we'll figure out. All right, so this is the interface you'll see, and you'll have two options here: get search volume and focus, and discover new keywords. You have to choose the discover new keywords section. And once this open up, you will start with a website. This is the important step. If you go here, you'll see this option: enter a website or a page to find keywords that match your site. This is where we'll find out what keywords Google associates, and especially what keywords does a particular website rank for in the Google search results, and how Google is associating a set of keywords with a particular page and a URL. For example, I'll just type in WP Forms here. So I'll just type in the URL, wpforms.com. And you have two options here: use the entire site or use only this page. In the beginning, I'd recommend that you use the second option, so you can figure out how or what keywords a particular page is ranking for. And instead of if you use the entire website, you might get a lot of jumbled up keywords, and it might be difficult to figure out what specific pages have what specific keywords. So by using this option, I'll click get results, and I'll see a bunch of keywords that Google actually associates with the homepage of this website or WP Forms. You'll see WP Forms, WordPress Forms. I'll just expand this column: WordPress Forms, WP Form, Gravity Forms, so many different keywords. I'm finding out that all these keywords and their monthly searches as well. And this is a great way to figure out what kind of keywords I can go after if I have a competing website. And what I can also do to find even more keywords is find out exactly specific pages that are created for highlighting certain features. So I'll pause the video for a second. I'll find out a couple of URLs on the site, and I'll explain this strategy once again. So I just went to WP Forms and figured out a blog post that I've recently written. So let me use only this page, and I'll use this URL. And you can see the URL here: ChatGPT plugins for WordPress. That's a blog post on the site. So even if, let's say, a website is just writing content and you want to compete with them on a specific set of keywords for a particular post, you can use this strategy. Click get results and figure out what specific keywords that page is ranking for, or what keywords is Google associating with that page as well, and also finding out search volume for those certain set of keywords. So WordPress create website, WordPress website, and see bunch of keywords that Google is actually ranking this page and also associating with this set of pages, or I'd say this particular page. And this gives you a lot of insight about what other keywords users might be searching for in your niche. What keywords is this page ranking for? And I'll give you insights about customer research, and you'll understand more what kind of keywords will users search for when they search or associate with the entire website. So this is step number one. Make note of this. You can download, or I'd say export, this keyword list easily using the interface right here. If you select this, you'll have an option of here for copy, export links. You can create a Google spreadsheet and collect all this and organize all this data there. So this is step number one. Now you've figured out what keywords to go after when you're writing content or even creating your website. So let's work on step number two, which is figuring out how much traffic is the competing website actually generating. There are several tools on the market which can help you identify and analyze this data, but my recommendation goes to this tool, which is SEMrush. It's a fantastic tool. If you haven't tried it, there's a link down in the description where you can use to sign up for a free account and do some of the things that I'm going to show you. Now, there are several things inside SEMrush that you can use. You can see there's so many different tools, but I don't want you to get overwhelmed. And let's start with a simple, I'd say, competitive research, which is right here. Inside competitive research, you have a domain overview, traffic analytics, organic research, keyword gap, and backlink gap. I'm going to start with the domain overview, which is something like this. It's the same page I had opened up. And what I'm going to do is just add the specific website or WP Forms that I just showed you before. So I'll place this entire URL. I'll just trim it down to the main URL. right here, and I'm go for a worldwide search. So I want to identify where the traffic is coming from throughout the world, not just a specific country. So I'll click the search button and SEMrush will go to work. It'll give you all the data I need to understand what kind of traffic they're generating, where the traffic is coming from, what are the most important pages, what are the most important keywords on the website. So just to give you an idea of what is going on here, we have an authority score of 53, which is an Intel metric by SEMrush. Organic search traffic, so almost 100,000 visitors per month coming. Page traffic search, number of backlinks, organic and paid distribution by country, 1 year traffic, 6 month traffic, 1 year traffic, and 1 month traffic, 2 years all time traffic. You can have SERP features, what kind of rich results is this website ranking for, organic keywords, organic research, all this here. So much data you can look for. You can also go into specifically traffic analytics, organic research, keyword gap, and backlink gap. And if you have your own website already live, you can plug in your website as well, and SEMrush will detect or compare how your website is in terms of content compared to your competing website. Let me show you also how traffic analytics looks like, and there's a lot of data you can work here. So again, you see number of visits, number of unique visitors, what pages, average visit duration, all those things that you will find, or I say important to understand what pages are the most important on this website. You'll see all of this here. You'll see an overview, an audience overview, traffic journey, top pages, subfolders. There's a lot of data. Again, you can spend a lot of time dissecting the data, but the most important thing that I'd recommend you figure out is what keywords are they ranking for, which was step number one. Also, what how much traffic are they getting and how much money are they spending on specific kind of keywords, man, because that are the keywords that are making the most money probably for them. So maybe that is something you need to figure out if you can outrank them organically, or I'd say you can rank organically for those set of keywords. Again, there's a lot of data you can work with, but the first important step to figure out what's the basic strategy that you need to implement based on all this data. All right, so without going into a lot more detail, this is all SEMrush can provide to you. Let's also talk about the third step, which is again more important. Or I'd say it's also very important, how are individual pages optimized on those websites, right? Let's talk about that method now. So let's talk about the third step now, which is figuring out how the individual pages on the website are optimized from a content standpoint. And the easiest way for you to do this would be just go on the website. Right now, I am on wpforms.com and I can make note of all the different optimizations that have been done on the website. So I can go here and look at the title of the page. So the title of the page is wpforms, the world's best drag and drop WordPress forms plugin. I can make note of that. I can see all the links that they've done, what the headline is like, and I can go into the code as well. So if I just press this button, I can go to the metadata and figure out what kind of metadata is being added, what's the meta description like, all those different things that optimize or is utilized for optimizing a page, I can actually figure out. Now, this can be done. Again, this is not something that's impossible to do, but it's not practical to do for a lot of different pages, and it's a lot of manual work. And if you're a beginner, you probably are overwhelmed by looking at this. You don't understand anything. So I'll give you another alternate way of figuring out, or I'd say generating a sophisticated report about individual pages, and that everything about pages can be done on your website correctly or on your website directly. So right now I'm inside my WordPress website, and this is a plugin that already installed. I would recommend that you install this plugin on your website as well. And this plugin provides tons of functionality in terms of SEO, but also comparative research. So the plugin is called All-in-One SEO. You can search for AIO SEO inside the plugin section. And this is the plugin. I already have it active on my website, and you can test out this plugin as well on your site. Once this is done, there's several tools inside this plugin. So you see the dashboard, the general settings, search appearance. You can optimize your entire website's SEO, or completely, I'd say, create a SEO strategy using this plugin. But what I'm interested in specifically for this video is the SEO analysis feature. And what this feature lets you do is figure out if your pages are correctly optimized and your entire website is correctly optimized on meta terms, or I'd say everything that needs to be optimized, but you can also do it for competing websites. So right now you're here, you see SEO audit checklist. This is just showing my website on how it's optimized, but if I go to analyze competitors' website, I can do this as well. You see, I already tried it out. I'll just delete it and do it once again. I'll just click here, paste the URL, I'll just delete this and search for just wpforms.com. I'll click this button, and this will generate a complete report of how this individual page has been optimized. And there's a lot of data which is very, very important, so I'll just dissect the data for you. So the first thing you see here is an overall score, which is 88 for the website, which is great. You see an overview of what are the important issues, what are recommended improvements, and what are good results. You also see a mobile snapshot, so you can understand how optimized this page is for mobile phones. You also see a complete recommendations, and I say complete analysis of the page. So you see what the search preview is going to look like, how it's going to appear in the search results, very important. Basic SEO, you see the length of the title. You can also go here and understand what's the title like. You can go to the meta description. It is set and how long it is. You can go here and figure out what the meta description is, what H1 tag, which is also important, was added. So this will give you a complete, I'd say, overview of all the data that has been optimized already on the page and also specifics of that page. So what you can do is also look at the data itself instead of always just seeing that something has been added or optimized. So you see how many H2s, what images have been added, and if images have alt tags, you see here some optimizations are remaining. You'll see images come up here as well. And for advanced SEO, you also see this page is using the canonical tag. Page does not have any no index tag. Both the WW and non-WW versions are redirected. So you see, understand, or I say you can get complete understanding of how this page is optimized in terms of content, in terms of, I say, meta information, and in terms of the content, you can just go to the page and figure out how much or what kind of content they have written. So this gives you a complete picture of how a specific page is optimized. And you can do this for individual pages as well, not just for a home page, but as I explained before, you can do the same thing for a specific page and figure out what kind of optimizations have been done on the place. So using these three steps that I just explained, you'll figure out the number of keywords that your particular website ranks for. You can make a note of that and export that. And you can figure out how much traffic does a website get from Google search and from paid channels, and do a complete analysis from what the links are coming from and all the other information. And using this tool, All-in-One SEO, inside All-in-One SEO, you can also figure out how the individual pages are optimized from a metadata standpoint, and you can just generate this for every single page, and this is completely free to use. Fantastic, right? So using these three steps, you'll have a complete idea of what the competition is doing to rank higher in Google search results, and then you can replicate the same strategies for your website as well. I hope you found this video helpful. If you still have questions about how to do more detailed competitive research, let me know in the comments. Don't forget that all the tools I mentioned are linked down in the description of this video. You can go check them out. If you want more videos like this, or if you have any specific ideas of videos we should make, mention those in the comments. Like this video, subscribe to this channel for more education just like this, and of course, you're watching Yuvraj from the WP Beginner team. I'll catch you in the next video. Take care.